Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Stop cheating at workplaces. Why do I say this, my beloved brothers and sisters? So many of us get employed. You have been employed, you receive your monthly salary, you earn your monthly salary, and then you keep on cheating at your workplace. If your work is meant to be from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m., you come 8:30 a.m. and then you leave 12 p.m. or 10 a.m. and then you tell those that would remain from 8 to 2 to write your name as well on the list, meaning to sign out your name for you to signify that you were in office from 8 a.m. to 2 p.m. or to 6 p.m. or to whatever time. Why would you cheat for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Let's ask ourselves, between you and Allah, how many people are out there searching for a job? Allah gave you this job, and here you are cheating. If you know you are not ready for the job, why don't you just resign and then let others have the space? Let others occupy the space. Let others have the space. Perhaps they will be much more responsible than you. How could you cheat? Cheated, subhanAllah. And then you receive your monthly salary. And then whenever there's a delay in terms of the payment, you are the first to complain when you did not work the entire month or you did not work the fixed time. This is a contract. When you receive your appointment later, don't you sign on there? Don't you read what is on there? Don't you read that you would come to work from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m.? Don't you read that whenever you can't come, you have to phone them to tell them the reason why you can't come? And they may permit you or not permit you, and things would be done properly. But instead, you end up cheating the entire week, weekdays, Monday to Friday, 8 to 6 p.m. You are only in office from 8 to 10 a.m. or to 11 a.m. or to whenever you even want. Some days you don't even come just because your boss doesn't regularly check on you. And then even if your boss checks on you, sometimes you may think you are wise, you would want to start bribing your boss not to report you. Beloved bosses, you know, my beloved bosses, or the boss and my beloved workers, from both sides, let's try to be honest. Let's try to remain honest. Why would you, boss, cover up for your worker cheating on time when there are others there who you denied them the work? You refused to employ them. You denied them, isn't it? Here I'm talking about bosses that have their own bosses as well. You have a company where there is a boss, and that boss has his own boss. So I'm talking of the second boss. You denied them the job, and then here you are trying to help your co-workers cheat on time. How can you do that? Beloved brothers and sisters, a Muslim is meant to be sincere. A Muslim is meant to be truthful. He's meant to be sincere. SubhanAllah, meant to be responsible. How can you do this? To cheat, to waste, you know, to deprive others of having that space, that opportunity to be employed. And here you are cheating on time. Beloved workers, beloved brothers and sisters, I'm calling you workers because, yes, you know, let's try to be honest. Let's try to be responsible. Don't cheat. Check time. You know, 8 a.m., 6 p.m., you're there. If you can't, resign, isn't it? You resign. In fact, maybe you would become happier when you resign, because you would never ever be happy when you cheat every day. You can't be happy. You can't. Allah instructs you and I to be just, isn't it? Inna Allah ya'amuru bil'adl, isn't it? SubhanAllah, Allah instructs you and I to be just. Inna Allah ya'muru bil'adl wal ihsan, isn't it? And goodness as well. Try to be good. Part of being good is when you are just, isn't it? Let's try to be honest. Let's try to be responsible. Don't cheat. Stay away. What would you achieve when you cheat? In fact, like I was saying, maybe if you resign, you'd become much more happy, because maybe now that you are cheating every time, you know, you don't even have time to spend with your family members. I am not encouraging you to resign. I'm just saying maybe, since you are not truthful, okay? Had it been you are responsible, then you would say, SubhanAllah, we can find other ways of you trying to spend time with your family members. But since you are not, why don't you just resign and then go there? Ya'muru bil adl wal ihsan wa ita'i dhil qurba, isn't it? Your relatives, isn't it? Family ties. Spend time with your family members. Do you? You don't. Okay, try. You can try. And Allah would help you. So my beloved brothers and sisters, I think, very important. Let's try to be honest. Let's try to be responsible. And Allah would open our doors way, way beyond what we think. May Allah make us become much more responsible. And may Allah make us become, you know, good workers and good bosses. And then, as well, don't plot against your co-workers. Just because you have a co-worker that is, you know, shining more than you are. When I say shining, maybe he knows how to do the work more than you. So everyone likes them and everyone wants them to do the work and not you sometimes. Kana Allah fi auni al-abdi, ma kana al-abdu fi auni akhihi. Allah continues to help his slave for as long as his slave continues to help his brother. Don't plot, help. From both sides, just help. Both sides, Allah would open your doors. May Allah open our doors. May Allah grant us goodness in this world and the next. May Allah make us become much more responsible. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.